Hello friends, I'm Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. I'm releasing a new video series on the concept of tree data structure. Here, I'm starting with the introduction to the tree data structures. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks. After subscribing it, keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of new videos of my channel. Now let's start with the content. First of all, I would like to request you to go through the different types of data structures. So this diagram will explain you the types of data structures. Mainly, there are two types. They are primitive data structures and non-primitive data structures. Primitive data structures, they are which we cannot derive. They are already available. And non-primitive data structures are the data structure that are derived from the primitive data structures. The non-primitive data structures are of again two types. They are linear data structure and non-linear data structure. Linear are which the data structure grows in the sequence or in a linear way. They are linear data structures. And the non-linear data structures which grows non-linearly or in the hierarchical way, it is called as non-linear data structures. If you want to know about details of the data structures, then you can go through my video which I am flashing over here. So you can continue with the video, that introduction to data structures, where I have explained all the different types of data structure with their examples. And in that, I am going to focus on the tree data structure. Here you can see that tree is a data structure which is non-linear data structure. So now let's start with the tree. Unlike different linear data structures, they are arrays, linked list, stack or queue that grows in the linear way. Unlike of these data structure, tree is a non-linear data structure, which is also called as hierarchical data structure. So trees, this is the data structure who grows in the non-linear fashion. The focus is on non-linear data structure. How this tree is going to be represented non-linearly, that I am going to explain you in the next slide. So here I am going to explain you some important topics or the concepts with respect to tree. So tree is a spatial data structure. That data structure is used to store the information. Whenever the user wants to store the information in the hierarchical way, in that case we can use the tree data structure. Now the next important topic is tree is represented as a node connected by different edges. How to represent the tree with the help of nodes and edges, that I am going to explain you with the help of this diagram. So there, this is the diagram where I am explaining you the important term or basic terminologies of the tree data structure. So basically these are whatever I have represented, A, B, C, D are the nodes, and these are the edges between both the nodes. So there are different terminologies which I have given over here. They are like, this is the somehow root. What is root? What is parent node? What is child node? What is sub tree? What are the siblings? What is leaf node? What are the levels? That I am going to explain you one by one in the next slide. So let's move to the next slide, where with the help of same diagram, I am going to explain you all the terms one by one. So let's start with the root. What is root? So always root. Here you can see this is the root for the given tree or a tree data structure. Here you can see that this is the hierarchical data structure which is represented non-linearly. This is not in the linear way. So root, what is root? The root node is at the top of the tree. The node which is available at the top of the tree is called as root node. Always remember, there is a single root for every tree. Every tree will be having only one root. And if the only one root is there, always for all the remaining nodes, there will be a single path from the root. So what is path? Path is nothing but in the way we are going to access the nodes. That I am going to explain you in detail once I will explain the concept or a term path. Now, time being, you just keep remember that the root node is present. Our root node is the very first node or the topmost node of the tree data structure. Here in this example, A is a root node. And the one more concept you need to keep in mind that every tree will be having a single unique root node. Let's move to the next term. Next term is a parent node. What is parent? Here I would like to explain you this. D is a parent of the child node H and I. B is a parent of the node D and E. A is a parent of the node B and C. So likewise, you must have to come to know that what do you mean by parent. So parent is nothing but any node except the root node which has one edge upward to a node called a parent. So always, this is the node which is having the two child nodes and which is having the upward edge. So this D is a parent of the child node H and I. We can say that A is also a parent node, but instead of parent node, we will refer this as a root node. Let's move to the next term, that is child node. As I have explained, parent in the side by side or in hand with the parent node, child node grows because the child node is the node below a given node connected by its edges downward is called a child node. So this is the parent node which is having the down edges, two down edges which are connected to the H and I. So H and I are the child node of the parent node D. So in this way, I am going to explain you the concept. Now for example, if I am having a B as a parent node, which are the child node for the parent node B? Yes, correct. They are D and E. Now let's consider C is a parent node. Which are the child nodes? F and G are the child nodes. Let's move forward for the next term, which is nothing but the leaf node. The leaf node. Here in this example, I have given that F is a leaf node. So what is leaf node? A leaf node which does not have any child node. It is called as a leaf node. A node which is not having any child node. That node is called as leaf node. So this is nothing but the leaf node. I'm sorry. Which remaining leaf nodes are there in this tree? Here we'll start with H. Yes, H is a leaf node. I. Yes, I is also leaf node. J. J is also leaf node. E. No, E is not a leaf node because E is having its child, which is J. E is a parent node. E is not a leaf node. F is a leaf node. G is also a leaf node. Here you can see that no any parent node will become the leaf node because the parent node is a parent because it is having its child nodes. And the leaf nodes are the nodes which are not having any children. They are the leaf nodes. So here we can say that yes, child node can be a leaf node, but leaf node cannot be a parent node. Here you have to remember this particular thing. Now subtree. Subtree where, for example, I have shown here or highlighted this is a subtree where D is a parent node and its child node are H and I is a subtree of this whole tree. Here if I am going to divide this tree where B is a parent node, D and E are their child nodes. D is a parent node, H and I are their child nodes, E is a parent node, J is its child node. So in this way we can say that this hole can also be a subtree of the whole tree whose root is A. Now whenever you are going to say this is a subtree, in this subtree D is going to become a root node. For this subtree, I repeat, for this subtree, D will be a root node. Let's move forward. For the next term is nothing but the levels. So levels are nothing but, or level is nothing but a term where level of the node represents the generation of the node. We can say that the generation. If we are going to take our family tree, our grandparent is the generation 0. Then the next generation is of our parents' generation, is the generation 1. The next generation, our generation, which is nothing but the level 3 or the generation 2. Sorry, level 2 or the generation 2. And the next generation will be at the next level. So in the same way, the tree also is organized level wise, that levels are nothing but the generation of that particular tree. Always, if we are going to consider that the root node is at level 0, means the generation 0, its child node are at the level 1. The next level, next generation will be at the next level, and so on. The levels will go in increase one by one. Let's move forward. For the next term for the same tree is nothing but the path. When I explain you the root node, at that time I have used the term path, and here I am explaining you that the term, what do you mean by path? So path refers to the sequence of the nodes along with the edges of a tree. So for example, from root node to the node J, what will be the path? So path is nothing but who refers the sequence of the nodes. So starting with node A, to go to J, I need to traverse it A to B, B to E, E to J via these different edges. A, B, B, E and E, J is nothing but the path from A to J. If I want to traverse it from A to H, the path will be A to B, B to D, D to H. Is nothing but the path from root node A to H. So I repeat, if a path starting from a root node to any of the node, there will be always a unique path or a single path to go to any of the node. Now next term is nothing but the visiting node. So visiting usually used whenever we want to traverse that particular path. So visiting refers to the checking the value of the node when in case of traversing or performing any another operation. So as I explained just now, if I want to traverse from A to J, so A to B, to traverse A to B, the visited nodes are A and B. From B to E, now the visited nodes are A, B and E. And the next edge which I am going to cover to traverse to J is E, J. And that's why the visiting nodes are A, B, E, J. It helps us that I reach to my destination, which is nothing but J, by indicating the visiting nodes. Next term is traversing. Traversing means passing through the nodes in a specific order. So again we'll take the same example, that is A to H. So I am traversing the nodes, I am passing the path, or I am going through the path, through the nodes, that is starting from node A through B, B to E on E to J. So I am traversing from A to J through B and E. So this is nothing but the traversing term. And the last term is nothing but the key. Key, always you, all of you are knowing, key is a term which is used to represent a value if we want to perform any of the search operation. So if any of the value I want to search, that value is termed as the key. Now let's move forward why we are going to study the concept or the data structure trees. So here I have used some of the examples where the tree is the best solution. So the first reason is whenever I want to store my information in the hierarchical form. For example, the file system on your computer. All of you are knowing this is the file system of your computer, or it is available in your computer. That is, my computer is having different drives. In that drive, different folders are there. So to represent this type of hierarchical information, I will prefer to use the tree. The another reason is why I am going to use the tree is whenever I want to perform or I want to perform different operations like accessing of the information or the searching of the information. So tree provides us the better way to perform the operation accessing the information or the searching of the information, which is quicker than the linked list and slower than that of the arrays. Array is the best solution actually, but if the linked list is there instead of linked list, the trees will give a better solution if we are having the BST. So what is BST? That I am going to cover one by one in this whole video series. So tree, whenever I want to perform this type of operation, the tree is the moderate way. Again, the tree provides the moderate solution for the insertion as well as the deletion operation as well. Instead of performing all these operations in linked list, if we will use the tree, which will be the moderate solution. And the last one, unlike an arrays or the trees or like the linked list, we don't have the upper limit in the trees. Arrays is having the upper bound because usually arrays are the what we can say static data structures where statically the memory will get allotted, but in linked list is a dynamic data structure. So like of the linked list, tree is also a dynamic data structure where there will not be any upper bound, upper limit or the maximum limit. Till the your computer permits, you can store the value. There will not be the upper limit. So these are different reasons why we are choosing the tree data structure for the implementation. Now here I am going to explain you what are different applications we can implement with the help of trees. So whenever you want to manipulate the hierarchical data or the formation of the multi-stage data, I will prefer to use the tree data structure. As I explained previously, that where you want to store the information hierarchically, where your file system is there, in that case we can use the tree data structure. Next one, the expression trees. To represent the trees or to represent the expression in the form of trees, the tree data structure is best suitable. Manipulation of the sorted list of the data, that is in the binary search tree. I'll explain all these things in detail one by one once we will start with the binary search tree. Time being, you just keep in mind that this is main application of the tree where we can manipulate the sorted list of data. As well as the router algorithms are there, many are the router algorithms who uses the tree for their implementation. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. I hope you are able to understand what I am trying to explain you. So please stay tuned with the channel Tech Talks. Please do not forget to give the comments. Whatever you want, more extra things, you can give as a comment. I'll try to fulfill all that comments. If you like the content, please like my video. Please subscribe my channel Tech Talks. And here I am providing you some of the shortcut link for next video of the series as well as the playlist for the same video series. Please stay tuned with Tech Talks. Thank you.